The recent drought that gripped the Horn of Africa saw a humanitarian crisis of extreme measures. As thousands of people were dying, the heart-wrenching media images were being broadcast internationally.
Like many of the patients at this hospital, they are victims of Somalia's drought, the worst in nearly 40 years.
It's tough enough for the adults, but many frail and hungry children don't manage to survive the trek. Officials at the UN Refugee Agency said this week the crisis is taking on unimaginable proportions.
This will be five times as bad come the end of the year if we don't act now. It's as simple as that.
They walk days in search of water. The drought in the Horn of Africa has grown so intense, a half million children are severely malnourished and at risk of death. Every day, hundreds die because of the drought and famine.
An international appeal for aid prompted the Al Imdad Foundation into action. A delegation touched down in Mogadishu, and in association with local government NGOs and international aid organizations, were able to assess the situation and deliver much-needed food aid and medical supplies. The emergency relief was distributed at various IDP camps in Mogadishu and surrounding areas. A second delegation from the Al Imdad Foundation's satellite offices in Australia, the United Kingdom and Zambia joined the plight a few weeks later. The IDP camps at this point was growing in number as people poured into the capital, Mogadishu.
This is one of the makeshift medical clinics initiated by the Al Imdad Foundation across the region, whereby IDPs come here, they see a doctor, and thereafter a prescription is given and the relevant medication handed over to the IDP.
دد إن لك الميو وحبرشده دد وحبرشده كبيرين عظماتك عمت إيجار كل اللي إيجار
أتراه أذهل جلال
الله they suffer from different diseases malnutrition is the most common diarrhea cough skin disease these are the most common we come across We treat them according to this, according to the patient's claim, sickness. What we need at the moment is systematic treatment. We don't have laboratory facilities, we don't have access to this. We just hear the patient complain and we give them this. What we do is that we do.
ويح نفسي فلم ترى وهي ترزف في سجود.
The Al Imdad Foundation is here at the Kalkal IDP camp here in Somalia, where we witnessed firsthand the conditions and the plight of our brothers and sisters here. Very saddening indeed. It has brought tears to the eye to see the conditions, and the appalling conditions indeed, of our people who are here. But the good news is that the Al Imdad Foundation is here, and we are now going to be rendering food aid to this community.
Traveled it almost 48 hours to reach Mogadishu, coming in from Perth, Western Australia. But subhanAllah, after seeing the condition, I think I did not make any sacrifice on my behalf. Coming here and seeing from the one IDP camp that we just walked through, Allahu Akbar, those kids don't have clothes on their bodies. They, Allahu Akbar, I think words cannot explain the situation that we find our Muslim brothers and sisters in. On behalf of Al Imdad Foundation Australia, the Muslim Charitable Foundation of Brisbane, the EFIC Muslims Australia, we thank Al Imdad Foundation South Africa, we thank Zamzam Foundation for making this possible for us to come firsthand to witness, and inshallah for our iman to increase in the gratitude and thanks unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakallah kulla khair.
Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, maliki yawm al-deen, iyaka na'bud wa iyaka nasta'in, i'dina as-sirata al-mustaqim, sirata al-ladhin al-amta alayhim, ghayri al-maghdubi alayhim, wa rabbalim.
Alhamdulillah, it's another day of work for the Al Imdad Foundation and its relief teams who are right here at the Malan camp in the Hulwadak district. And as you can see behind me, the status of these impoverished people and their condition and their dire need and their dire condition indeed. It brings a tear once again to the eye to witness this. But the good news is that we are here, and like this in many different other camps, and there are hundreds of these kind of camps in and around Somalia, and the Al Imdad Foundation is now making its presence in all of these camps, or most of these camps, inshallah.
Alhamdulillah, thanks to the generous contributions from the Muslims all over Australia and our partner organizations who we are assisting, the Muslim Charitable Foundation, EFIC Muslims Australia. We are here on the ground at one of the IDP camps in Mogadishu, and this morning we are visiting one of the makeshift small medical centers which has been set up by the Al Imdad Foundation South Africa, our head office, Al Imdad Foundation Australia and Al Imdad Foundation UK. And alhamdulillah, we find that hundreds and hundreds of old, young people who have traveled 200-300 kilometers by foot, they are here this morning trying to come and get themselves some medical treatment by the doctors employed by the Al Imdad Foundation.
يعز على المرء أن لا يرى شباب الهداية يأبى الخبر ويكره قلبي دليل الخطى فتى بين أترابه محتقر فتى حطم الكفر أسلفه فحطمه الكفر لم.
The delegation visited the local hospital and found the facilities limited and medical supplies in much need. Therefore, the Al Imdad Foundation has looked into building and facilitation of a new hospital as a long-term project for the people of Somalia.
Somalia is a forgotten land by our people, and I think because we are part of Africa and this is the Horn of Africa, we need to get together and we have to put our act together and we have to look at situations like what we have seen in Somalia. And once we relay to the community of Zambia the first hand information, inshallah, the way I look at it is it will be a way forward for our community, and we look forward that support in big numbers will come through, inshallah.
The people of Somalia had been brought to its knees yet again, and with the help of the generous contributions of those who make it possible, Somalia can rise again.